On completion of this chapter, you will have an understanding of the standard procedures when a crude oil tanker arrives at port, who is responsible for the various activities, the procedures when port authorities and terminal staff embark. What are the standard arrival procedures? When the vessel arrives at port, she passes through the standard activities. Pilot on board, entering into port, and moving alongside terminal or SBM buoy assisted by tugboats. Who is responsible for the various tasks? As soon as information on which side alongside has been received, the bosun and the crew make ready the moorings and, together with the pumpman, prepare the cargo manifolds. When well moored and the pilot and tugboats are off, the security checkpoint is established at the gangway and the vessel's port watch system enters into force. When the vessel is cleared by quarantine and customs authorities, the loading master or terminal representative and cargo surveyors board the vessel. The cargo surveyors are representing the shippers and cargo owners or charterers. The loading master and his terminal staff or crew normally inspect the vessel's manifolds and mooring arrangement before connection of hoses or arms is initiated. From the vessel's side, the duty deck officer is now in charge of the activities on deck under the supervision of the chief officer. When berthed to an SBM for loading through floating hoses, the hose connection operation is more demanding and requires experienced hands in addition to supervision of a loading master or his assistant. What are the three main subjects that must be discussed and agreed to in a ship-shore meeting between the chief officer and the loading master? A ship-shore meeting is held in the chief officer's office or cargo control room, or CCR, or ship's conference room, for pre-transfer exchange of information. The three main areas covered are the loading plan, the safety, security and environment protection, and the communication and emergency stop procedures. Details of the ship's loading plan, usually also communicated before arrival, are discussed, and if in agreement with the terminal's plans, are finalized. The items normally revised and added will be the time schedule, including loading rates on starting and topping off, deballasting operation, ship and shore tank changeover, avoidance of contamination of cargo, and pipeline clearing on completion of loading. Safety, security and environmental protection regulations of the ship as well as the terminal are important matters to be discussed and agreed on. Finally, the communications channels and emergency stop procedures are explained and tested. Click on the buttons below to view detailed checklists for various areas to be covered in this ship-shore pre-transfer meeting. Information from tanker to terminal. Information from the terminal to the tanker. Agreed loading plan. Ship-shore safety checklist. Ship-shore radio communications test and emergency stops. Posted plans and placards. Posted plans and placards. Ship-shore radio communications test and emergency stops. Posted plans and placards.